Palma on the day before the start of the TP52 World Championships. Just set the scene for us. Palma, one of the glamour venues on the circuit.
Yeah, for sure. Palma is fantastic. It's a huge bay here that we get to sail in, and it's kind of funny being here this time of year. Usually the bay is full of sailboats, and we're out there, just 10 of us race boats ready to go, and the whole bay is empty. It's just the whole playground is there for us to use this week, and it's going to be it's really going to be a lot of fun. It's one of our favorite places to race. It's a really great place for sailing.
You had some success here last year winning the Med Cup event. Terry and a few of the other guys went on to win the Copa del Rey as well that year.
Yeah, exactly. Last season we won the Med Cup event here in the Breitling. And then, Terry won the King's Cup straight after that. And then in this season as well, there was a group of us sailing in the King's Cup and a couple of winners in their divisions this season and the Copa del Rey and some other good results. So we know the place pretty well, and we're pretty happy to be sailing here.
Last year you sailed in Puerto Patals, just around the corner. Is this part of the bay different anyway?
It's not that different. I think even when we were sailing in Portales, we still use a similar race courses here. We would come out and come around the corner and come down here. So it's not that different. The biggest thing is that it's October. It's a different time of year. Normally we're here in July or August. So to be here in October is definitely different. And one of the biggest differences is it'll probably be a little bit lighter air, because it's just not as warm on shore, so the sea breeze doesn't kick in as well as it does normally in the summer. So it's, you know, a lot of the trends are still there and that we see normally in the summer, but it's just slightly different this time of year. It's a little cooler.
Preparation-wise, we saw some practice starts yesterday and then the official practice race today. You guys were looking at two new mainsails, I think M11 and M12 yesterday. What did you notice and what have you decided to use?
Well, M11 actually is not brand new. We used it a bit in the last event. It's our light air mainsail, and it's really beautiful. We use it today in the practice race, and the M12 is fantastic as well. We've done a couple of tickle ups to the luff curve in the last day or so, and we used it a bit at the end of the day today and really like it. So I think that, it's a pretty nice place to be, that we've got three really nice mainsails for this event, so we can pick and choose depending on the conditions. It's a little bit unusual for us to have that situation, because normally we're a one mainsail program where we use one mainsail straight from light air all the way through to heavy air. But for this event, now that we've got all the sails from the Med Cup available, we've got 10, 11, and 12, which are all three really nice sails, so they may be a little slightly better in different wind ranges, and so we might be changing mainsails a bit more between races than we normally do this event.
One of the interesting things that was discussed on the boat leaving yesterday was staking your claim at the one end of the course, at the one end of the start line at least, which was the pin end, which you worked very hard on doing yesterday, which seemed to have paid off today, because you guys had a great start, picked your lane, as few tucks as possible, and ended up winning the practice race today.
Yeah, exactly. It's funny, the conditions here, there's a certain sea breeze that wraps around the peninsula out to the left-hand side of the race course, and that gives you usually a pretty good advantage up in the top left-hand side of the race course, so it puts a premium on winning the pin unless the boat end's very favored. And we definitely wanted to kind of let everybody know that we were, if that was the right condition, we were going to be fighting hard for it, and that they, you know, leave it to us, because we're not going to let too many boats get off that end if we're down there. So we're tried to be a little bit intimidating the last couple of days, and like you say, it did work today, so it was good.
Managed to hold off Matador, who were fighting hard for second place. Matador and Artemis, the two new boats from the season, have been pretty strong in the light air, so you must have been delighted with that.
Yeah, exactly. I think that we've done a really nice work. Quantum's done a fantastic job with mainsail development this season, and the boats, like you say, Matador and Artemis, who were really quick in the light stuff in Alicante at the first event of the season, you know, they were noticeably faster than we were. We've really closed that gap nicely just through mainsail development, which is fantastic, and it's a big testament to the work that Quantum's put into this, obviously, and you know, it's the reason we're here, is to work with Quantum and get the sails as fast as possible, and have a good group like Quantum supporting us is fantastic, and you know, they've done really nice work to close that gap, and you know, you'd say that we were one of the quicker boats on the race course today, which is really nice.
You guys are defending champions, all to play for tomorrow.
Exactly. We'll go out there and fight hard and hope to do it. See what happens.
Good luck, Tommy. Good luck tomorrow and for the rest of the week. Thanks.
Thank you. Okay,